Hi everyone, welcome back for another video. In this video, we are going to be setting up Docker and Portainer. And I have one GPU that I'll be sharing with all my Docker containers. Whether you are a developer or IT professional, this video will show you the benefits of using Docker containers. Docker is a platform that makes it easy to deploy, package, and run your applications in containers. And a container is a lightweight and portable unit that contains everything that your application needs to run, including appropriate libraries and application code itself. I'll be using Docker containers to do my media management and data science workflows. And Portainer makes it easy to manage your Docker containers using a web interface. Let's get started. Okay guys, before we start installing Docker and Portainer, here is a quick overview of what we're trying to build. So I've already built half of our network. So the switches is installed, pfSense is installed. You can watch a video on my channel. I've already set up the networking and we are now moving to the right side of the pfSense, and that is the LAN network. I've already deployed PyHole as my network ad blocker. So in this video, we will be focusing on this part of the network. So I am going to deploy my media server on my Oasis VM, and I'll be installing Docker and Portainer. And in the next video, we'll be installing all these media management softwares using Portainer. Let's get started. So Oasis is going to be our media server, which we set up in the previous video. It is up and running just now. So I am going to SSH into this. I'm going to start configuring it and prepare it to install Docker and Portainer. So I've already SSH'd into it. The first thing is, let's update it. Enter. And we are going to make sure everything is upgraded. There's nothing to be updated, but just in case I run this as well, just to make sure. Now I am going to install a couple of packages. So sudo apt install git. And then I am going to set my time zone. So sudo time date ctl set time zone. So the next thing, we are going to install a couple more packages so that we can mount network drives. So sudo apt install sifs utils. So that's one, to load our Samba shares. And I am also going to do NFS common for our NFS shares. I prefer my editor to be Vim, so I'm going to install that as well. Before I attach my GPU to it, let me run few commands here so that it does not load any built-in GPU graphic drivers. Paste here, and I am also going to install some more packages. So these packages are for my NVIDIA drivers. That's done, and I am going to update my initram fs. And now I am going to shut down this VM, and I am going to SSH into my Proxmox. Now go to etc pve qemu server location and edit the configuration file for the VM. I am going to edit my 201.conf file because that's my VM's ID. So let's do that. And here I'm gonna append this line, and I'm going to add comma hidden equals one. This is important to let VM know that it is not a virtual machine so that it can recognize my GPU pass through. So that's all you needed. Save this. go back to Proxmox, click hardware, add a PCI device, and look for your GPU here. Mine is NVIDIA Quadro, this one, NVIDIA Quadro P600, and leave everything as is. Click add, and I am also going to add my audio device, and that's here. My audio definition, click add. Once that's done, make sure you untick the ROM bar as well. So click edit, untick this ROM bar, go to console, start the VM. So it's booting up. Let's SSH back into the server and first check if we can see NVIDIA GPU in our VM, and we can at 10 and 11. So now we are ready to download NVIDIA drivers. So go on to this website and put in the details about your GPU, click search, click download, right click, copy link, and just wget it. So that's been downloaded. We are ready to install it. So just type in sudo bash, the file name, enter, and it will go ahead and install the GPU driver. Enter. Yes. I usually click yes here. Enter. Now the driver is installed. So let's see if we can see our GPU. You can run the command NVIDIA-SMI. And if you see an output like this, that means that the driver has been installed successfully. So I can see that my Quadro P600 here, 39 degrees Celsius temperature, is 2GB card, and it's ready to be used. Now we are ready to install Docker. The first command I usually run is to make sure there are no pre-existing Docker engine or container RD is installed. So this will make sure that it removes them first. So there was nothing already installed. So we can move on to the next step. So we are going to update our system, and then we are going to install these packages. So enter. I'm going to make a keyrings directory at /etc/apt, and I am going to add Docker's official GPG key in there. So enter keyrings. So there it is, docker.gpg. Set up the Docker repository, enter, and then we are going to update package index again so that it can pull the latest Docker versions. So enter. I am going to install the latest Docker engine, container RD, and Docker compose. If you do install Docker CE, that's the community version, CLI, container RD, and compose plugin, enter, and yes. And lastly, I am going to add my user into the Docker group. So enter that, and if I exit it and SSH back in again, and if I run Docker version without sudo, and if I see any output, that means that Docker is installed properly. Now before we install Portainer, we need to install NVIDIA drivers for Docker so that we can use our GPU within Docker, and I can pass this GPU to any Docker images I want. So for that, I need to run some commands, and these commands are available on NVIDIA's website. So let me open that. So the first command is to set up the package repository and the GPG key. So enter that. Now we need to update our system, and we are ready to install the toolkit using NVIDIA-Docker2 package. And once that's installed, we need to restart Docker. So now at this point, a working setup we can test by running this command. So this will pull NVIDIA CUDA, this version, and the base Ubuntu 20.04 NVIDIA SMI. So now that the NVIDIA toolkit is installed, we can check to see if our Docker containers can utilize our GPU by running this command. But this command looks old according to the documentation, and it's for Ubuntu 20.04, but we are using Ubuntu 22.04. So we can go to the Docker Hub, NVIDIA/CUDA repository. You just search for Ubuntu 22 and you see a list. And I am interested in this one. So if I copy this, in fact, if I copy this here, go back, hit space, and then I can delete all that and append NVIDIA-SMI, enter. And if we see a similar output, what I've shown you before, when we install the NVIDIA drivers, then we know that our Docker images can utilize our GPU. So let's see. And here we go. So that means that our Docker images can utilize our GPU within its containers. So now we are ready to install Portainer. So first thing, we are going to create a Docker volume. So the first, we are going to create Portainer volume that will contain Portainer data. So let's do that. Now we are ready to install and run Portainer by this command. So let me go through this. So Docker run 8000 and 9443 to 9443. So this is from host to container ports mapping. And then we're going to call it Portainer. Restart always. And we are mounting some volume. So this is the Docker SOC volume and the one that we just created, Portainer data. And this is the image name, Portainer/Portainer-CE, latest image. So just hit enter. So it's pulling down the Portainer image and it will create a container, and we should be able to access it using the IP address of this server on port 9443. So that's created. Let's look at Docker PS. So here's the image name, the container ID was created 6 seconds ago, and these are the ports that it's available on. So if we go back, and that's HTTPS. Enter, show details, and Portainer is installed. And here is the username, and we can also set the password now. So let's do that. And it brings us to this page, environment wizard. So I'm going to use that, get started. So this is our local Docker environment. The first thing you'll notice is, even though we've installed our GPU, but Portainer hasn't registered it. So it says zero GPU. So let's set that up. So click environments, local, and hardware acceleration. We can add our GPU here. So we need to give it a GPU name and the UUID. So you can get that from this location. So if we go to CD, proc driver, NVIDIA GPUs. And if I do ls, that's my GPU there. So I can go in there. And if I do cat information, it gives me a model name and it also gives me the UUID. So let's copy this, go back, paste here, and let's copy the UUID, enter, and just click update environment. And now if I go to home, you can see there is one GPU here. And if I create any, now if I create any containers like Plex, I can pass this GPU to the Plex container, and it should be able to render or use this GPU without any issues. Using Docker and Portainer is a great way to streamline your workflow and improve the performance of your application by sharing one GPU among multiple containers. You are maximizing your GPU resource and improving the performance of your applications. In the next video, I'll show you how I use Docker and Portainer for media management, and I'll show you how you can pass your GPU to a Docker container such as Plex. See you there.